One of the key themes here at Sibos is managing risk. And we're all aware that some of the major risks that businesses and financial markets face over the coming years are those related to environmental, social and corporate governance, ESG.
Well, climate change and resource protection are risks that we all need to understand better and be prepared to manage. But the corporate world and the financial ecosystem also need to be more engaged with social challenges, such as growing economic inequality, diversity, inclusion and economic opportunity.
For a look at the main challenges that capital markets face in this area, we're joined now by Isabel Usher, Chief Executive Officer of Euronext Lisbon and Interbolsa. Hello, Isabel. Thank you very much for joining us here at Sibos TV. If I might start by asking, what is the role of the stock exchanges in the energy transition?
Hello, it's a real pleasure to be here. And thank you for inviting me for this great event. Indeed, stock exchanges have a critical role to play in promoting and helping energy transition and enabling sustainable finance more in general. You know that huge amounts of investment will have to be made in the coming years if we are to overcome this enormous challenge, which is, to get into the transition that is needed. The commitments of countries these days, 70% of GDP, of world GDP countries have committed to achieve the net zero carbon in 2050, but only 10% of the investment has been done so far. So as I said, we need to channel, and stock exchanges are the very important infrastructures that can allow this to channel huge amounts of savings to make these big investments possible. Just to give you an example, EDP is the Portuguese largest energy utility company, and they have, over the last 12 months, they have raised 2.5 billion euros to finance their solar and wind energy investments, not only in Portugal, but also in other European countries and also in the US, as they have large investments there. So at Euronext, we support both issuers and investors in this road. So issuers to help them fine-tune strategies and better communicate with their investors, and as you know, ESG investors are also growing. And investors on the other side help them to find the data and also to build portfolios where ESG factors are taken into consideration, like, for example, indices activity.
And given that, Isabel, has Euronext itself made any changes on its own strategy so that it can accommodate ESG principles?
Yeah, indeed, as the leading market infrastructure in Europe, Euronext is also leading the sustainable finance agenda in Europe. And we did have to change, to embed ESG in all our activities, being our portfolio of products and services, but as well as in our behavior as a company. So the first thing we did was to include an ESG pillar in our strategy. So if you look at our current strategy, you will see six pillars. One of the six pillars is called Enable Sustainable Finance. So all our business units have been embedding, these principles and finding products and services that help to push this agenda. And all our leaders, or our managers and managing board members, they are their compensation depends on them achieving these objectives. So we have been giving a lot of attention to this, and as such, over the last few years, we have already developed a good number of products and services around ESG. But also, as a company, in our behavior, We have been including more actively, you know, diversity principles on recruiting, for example, and inclusion principles as well. Just to give you an example, we now have three CEOs, leaders of stock exchanges in Euronext Group, Portugal, France, and Holland, which did not happen just a few years ago. We are also computing our carbon footprint. It's a project that we started also a few years ago, and we are now getting ready to do the next step, which is setting objectives to reduce this carbon footprint. And we have also embedded a significant number of policies around the usage of plastic, so reducing significantly the usage of plastic, of energy, of water, and now also reviewing our traveling policy, car policy. So it's a road where we are indeed committing very significantly to this agenda.
Isabel, finally, and briefly, if you will, sadly, we're running short for time, but let's touch on customers. Are you seeing a demand from them for more ESG products and services?
Absolutely, yes. Indeed, there is a fast growing demand for ESG products and services. Just give you two examples. On bonds, we have a segment which is designated to ESG bonds. So issuers, companies that need to invest in transition, for example, or in other areas can issue green bonds or social bonds or sustainability linked bonds. And this, the issuance of these bonds has been increasing very fast. So over the last 3 years, it has doubled every year. And this year, this trend continues. Another example, and we are reaching around 250 billion of these ESG bonds in our markets. Another example is on indices. As you know, there is a growing trend to passive investments, so portfolios which are indexed to indices, almost 90% of the indices that the Euronext Group has produced over the last 2 or 3 years are ESG, are all ESG indices. First of all, in benchmark indices, so like the ESG CAC 40 in France, for example, but also European indices like the ESG Large 80, and we are reaching about 50 families of ESG indices, just to give you briefly two examples.
Well, thank you very much for both of them. Sorry to cut you a little bit short, Isabel Usher, Chief Executive Officer of Euronext Lisbon and Interbolsa. Enjoy sunny Lisbon as much as we're enjoying this lovely studio here in Crawley. Thank you so much for joining us on Cybos TV.
It was a pleasure.